welcome. How long have you been in town, and what should we expect as you are sending in as a new ambassador?
First of all, honorable minister, I would like first to thank you for this appointment. It is an honor for me to meet with you, with deputy ministers and your staff. I have been in town since 2 months, and I really like and enjoy being in Accra. As you rightly mentioned, we have had close relations since the independence of Ghana. Indeed, we first opened an embassy during the second half of 1960s. Although we had to close it in 1980s, luckily since 2009, our embassy has been here in Ghana, working very closely with the Ghana Nations ministries. We are determined to be a development partner for Ghana. Our construction companies have invested more than $500 million so far in the country. What they have achieved so far proves that they are a good partner for the development efforts of Ghana, in line with the program of Ghana Beyond Aid, and as well as other flagship projects. Car Power has been producing a considerable amount of the energy needed by Ghana. The ship is currently at the Tema port. There are many other projects which have been either in the process of being completed or have already been completed in the country. We see many other opportunities in the sectors which Ghana has recently, Ghanaian authorities made an emphasis. These are agriculture and tourism, that these sectors can open up new avenues for us for further cooperation, to enhance our cooperation. And our aim target for bilateral trade volume is $1 billion. We believe that we can reach to this target to the benefit of both countries.
Well, thank you and welcome once again. On behalf of the President, the government and people of Ghana, we welcome you to Ghana. As you mentioned, we've had a very good relationship with Turkey for decades now. There are about three major areas of cooperation, as you mentioned. First is in the area of foreign direct investment. Currently, you are doing about 400 million thereabout, and like you mentioned, your target is to scale it up to about a billion.
Yes.
And it's very welcome. Safe to say that a lot of it is trade or foreign direct investment coming into sectors, as you've mentioned, that you find as interesting openings, such as agriculture and tourism. And they are also very important sectors to us. The President has led us to champion a new vision, as you hinted, which is the Ghana Beyond Aid vision, which also means that, among other things, we should focus a lot of emphasis on being self-reliant. And one of the areas we are looking at, yes, apart from agricultural industry, is industrialization. And Turkey has done pretty well in that space as well. And so we'll be looking to see a lot more foreign direct investment also in, coming into the industrialization space, where we have an opportunity to add value to a lot of our agric-based products that are grown across the country. That's the first area. The second area has got to do with trade, and as you mentioned, about 400 million that you want to ramp up to about a billion. Just that a lot of it is coming from Turkey into Ghana. We believe in that cooperation, but we also want to have a lot of trade growing the other way as well. And I think last year, when we had an opportunity to engage with your predecessor, we mentioned the fact that we should explore ways by which we can also open up the Turkish markets to some of the very beautiful Ghanaian products. Some of them are traditional exports, cultural products as well. That can also find expression in the Turkish markets and from Turkey as a hub into the entire sub-region. And so that is one thing that we would like to work with you keenly on, how to open up the Turkish markets, also to allow a lot of trade outbound into Turkey and into the sub-region. It will, among other things, help us to earn hard currency and support our currency here in Ghana. I'm sure you've heard a bit about our currency in the last few weeks as you came by. The final thing also is that as the Ghanaian economy is resurging, our capital markets are also booming, and we have a lot of interesting capital market products that investors from all over the world like to put money in. Indeed, as I'm speaking to you now, the Ghanaian delegation is in Europe trying to wrap up our Eurobond roadshow. And beyond this, there are many other capital market products that we always float on the global market. And it would be lovely to have Turkish investors pay attention therein, and also put some good money into those money market and capital market products. You make some good returns, and there's a lot of safety associated with Ghanaian market products. So these are three areas that we're also happy to work with you on. We look forward to enjoying our relationship with you here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I believe that long-term commercial relations can only be established on a mutual basis. I believe as there are opportunities for more opportunities for Turkish products in the Ghanaian market, same wise, there are more opportunities for the Ghanaian made products in the Turkish market. In order to increase our bilateral trade volume, we need to keep regular meetings of the businessmen of both countries continue. We have several businessmen associations who are particularly focused on bilateral cooperation in all sectors, not only trade but also in investment with Ghana. So I believe that in the during the coming months, we will be able to work together with the relevant Ghanaian authorities to bring them together again, so that they will have the opportunity to further discuss on how to enhance bilateral economic cooperation.
Very well, very well. Once again, you're welcome. We are happy to have you here, and we look forward to deepening our relationship with you.
Thank you
so much. Thank you so much.